Hi, I'm Jim Booker with HorizonHobby.com. Today I've got a very elegant and a very interesting looking airplane that many modelers are very familiar with, and this is a new offering from Parkzone. It's got all the typical Parkzone features, such as the Z-foam construction and just overall a lot of neat scale detail and very easy construction. I've got Eric Johnson with me, and Eric's with Parkzone, and he's had a big hand in the development of this airplane, and so he's going to really help us through all the features of this, but I think you're going to be very interested in this airplane. It's a little different approach, and I'm just loving this thing. It has a really distinct look, especially when it's flying, so you're going to like this one. Eric, what do you got here? Where did the idea for the Stinson SR-10 come from in you guys' mind? I know some of the guys there, and they're thinking of these kind of things, but...
Well, first of all, you know, we had not done anything in this class in the civilian, you know, size as far as this class. We've done a lot of the Warbirds, of course, the 480 size, but we really wanted to do something that was a little bit off the path, maybe something a little bit different. We love Warbirds. We'll continue to hit Warbirds. But doing something that in a new class was important to us, and this Stinson, of course, is, as Jim alluded to, is a very recognizable airplane. It's got a great, elegant look, classic, and frankly, a lot of it came from... having the opportunity to walk at Oshkosh several years ago and walk down the, you know, where the great planes are, and we are able to go and just take a look and see some of the very unique and classic airplanes such as the Stinson would belong to, and thought, you know, that's got to be a great plane to do. And so from that point on, a couple of us decided, you know, when we decide to do something in this class, something that's not a Warbird, something that's civilian, what better plane to do than a Stinson? And we thought, let's go for it.
Yeah, this is cool. Well, you know, it's important to have a round engine. That F4F, that was very cool too. It had the round radial engine, and a lot of airplanes from the 1930s did. But now, first of all, this is available as what? Both plug and play and bind and fly,
correct,
right?
Correct, yeah. Bind and fly and plug and play. And of course, the bind and fly includes everything except for the transmitter. It includes the Spectrum full range sport receiver. It includes the battery pack, the charger. Everything's installed, motor. The only thing you need to add to it is to add your own DSM to full range transmitter.
Okay. Now, this thing, the way it comes out of the box is a full four channel airplane, right?
Full channel right out of the box. But one thing that we've added to, and that's the ability to easily add a flap option to this. And so how we've done that is that all the hardware is included. All you have to do is add the servo. There's a nice little pocket on the underside of the wing that you can just install the servo into. In a matter of 15 minutes, you've got the full flap option. So that kind of adds to the scale features, of course, and adds to the flying. But the great thing about this airplane is that it's not needed. It's a cool thing to add, but it really slows down nicely even without the flap option.
Okay, well, you were speaking of scale detail. Well, now, this landing gear is just outrageous. I mean, the fairings, the wheel pants, the whole thing, and it all just, it just fits so well there. Is there any difficulty in assembling any of this stuff?
No, it's actually very, very easy. As you see with our typical Parkzone stuff, it's really a longer time to charge the battery pack than it is to finish the assembly.
Build the airplane.
Most of it's done. It's a matter of, 15 minutes worth of final assembly or whatever. We're proud of this airplane. We've added a lot of that scale detail, and not just the landing gear fairing, like you said, but we worked hard on the molded ribs up on the wing and the full shape of the wing. It's a scale outline, of course. We've also got some of that same ribbing in the stabilizer. And so you can see, obviously, the cowl, the way that it's shaped, of course, is scale.
The windshield there is
the windshield,
cool.
Everything about it. We've worked really hard. We're really proud of it. And it's one thing to look great, but I will tell you, it flies just as good as it looks, too.
Well, that's the next thing we want to get to. Talk about the flying a little bit. This is a high-wing airplane, and I notice it's got a semi-symmetrical airfoil, so it probably will do reasonable aerobatics.
It flies a lot like, as a short-term kind of talk, we'd say it's kind of like the high-wing tail dragger T-28. I mean, it flies a lot like the T-28. So for the guys that have loved the way the T-28 flies, and of course, those guys know it slows down really, really nice, but it also is, you know, lots of aerobatic type capabilities. This is very similar. So when you want to do shoot touch and goes with the trike gear and the low wing, then we say the T-28's great. If you want to do it with the tail dragger and with a real classic look of this high wing aircraft,
yeah,
then this is great too. This presents some very very well in the sky with a nice blue sky with the red trim. It's got the big fuselage and long wing, so I mean, it actually, in my opinion, presents itself larger than what it is. It's great. It's easy to see. It's very, very stable, and it's just a blast to shoot touch and goes and just fly. It's a lot of fun.
Now, you mentioned the long wing, and this is, what, 49-inch wingspan, I think the specs say?
I can't remember. It's something close to that.
So it'll fit in most people's cars, but
sure.
I know you've got some features built into this thing that makes it easy to assemble or disassemble.
Sure. Yeah.
What having we've done to do is, with the wing struts, right?
Yeah, what we've done with the wing struts is, as you can see, we've got two different wing struts pins on this particular aircraft. And one of them you see is like almost like you see like on an A-scale, you know, buggy or something, where a body pin, where you can just pull them, a quick release, and basically then the wing will lift right off. You just have to unscrew the wing, and then, you know, obviously you've got the leads of the ailerons. But it's really what we call almost like a quick release type pin. On the other side, we've got, it's more of an L-shaped pin, in which if you've got a car that hey, I'm not even going to bother to take this thing apart. Although it's good size, it's not too big, so it easily fits in most vehicles, whether you're driving a minivan or I can put it in the trunk of my car very, very easily, and even the back seat of my car. So the guy that says, I'm not going to bother with taking the wing off and on, we include these little L-pins that slide in, or less noticeable, and you just simply tape around them, and then it holds the wing on.
Okay.
So we include both sets, so that way the consumer can try the one they want to do, and maybe they decide at first they're going to put the quick release pins, and then later decide, I'm not going to take the wing off, and they may decide to go ahead and put the L pins on. But that way, it's up to them.
But it's not necessary to remove the wing to replace the battery between flights or anything,
no,
right?
No. The battery, I'll just kind of hold up. The battery's underneath. It's got a really easy compartment there. You simply open it up, slide the battery in. The compartment is actually quite large, so it'll accept all 1800 to 2200 size 3-cell LiPos, so that makes it easy. The only time you need for the wing is the initial, if you wanted to, when you initially to
put
build
it,
and you may never, ever take it off.
This airplane is just going to be fun flyer, people going to the flying field on Sunday and having an airplane they can be proud of.
We had the opportunity last month to go to a big show in England. There was a couple of us that got to go, and we were able to take this to an all-grass field.
Yeah.
And, of course, it was short grass. But it was great because you kind of had that scale feeling of being back in the 1930s where everything was pretty much grass runway
fields,
anyway.
Yeah.
And landing it on short grass, takeoff, touch and goes, it was a great, great experience. And it's got a very true, reliable power system. The exactly the same power system comes in the T28. So guys are very familiar with that. The same motor, same prop, same speed control, same battery. It works out great that way because people tend to have lots of those batteries and
have
spare propellers and stuff like that. So works out great, flies great. As you alluded to earlier, you can either slow it down and do some really scale takeoffs on this are so much fun. You can stand behind the airplane and watch the mains lift and then the tail start to come up afterwards and landing the same way. I think most guys will land this in 2-point. 3-point's quite difficult because of the way the airplane, the high angle of attack, but it's great landing on its mains and then watching the tail kind of drop
the tail.
It's a lot of fun.
Well, let's see. You mentioned a number of things there. The 480 motor, similar and same as a T28, same propeller, basically same battery.
30 amp speed control.
Yeah. So there's really, in terms of all that equipment that we've come to rely on in all these airplanes, that part should be just a non-issue for everybody. They may have batteries and
that's right.
Lots of accessories. I assume we'll see it shortly this summer?
Yeah. It's due to release, we say September. We're very safe about that date. And so we want to make sure we get plenty of flying season left. And, it's the prototypes that we're flying are just flying fantastically. Guys are fighting about taking them home one night because it's my turn to take mine home tonight. And you got to make sure you bring it back the next day. Somebody else is waiting. So kind of the same thing we got with the T28 where guys, once they flew it, they just had to have one.
You have to always take it to the field no matter what else you take.
That's
you
right.
Have the
this has got that same Stinson type thing. I showed a friend of mine the other day who was convinced he was buying the T28.
He was already.
Now he says, wait a minute. Now I may buy the Stinson. He's kind of mad because now he's not sure which one he wants to buy first. I told him you got to get them both.
Yeah, that's the easy solution. Just
get
both. It's no problem. Really, you're going to have more than one airplane. Don't get hung up on this
stuff. He's trying to decide which one first.
Yeah.
So, anyway.
Okay, well, I appreciate everybody stopping by and taking a look at our Stinson SR-10 preview here. Eric's done a great job on this airplane, and I think you'll appreciate what comes in this package. So thanks for viewing, and I hope you'll return again to horizonhobby.com, and we'll check out some new airplanes as they become available.